NBA 2K22 Season 2 is upon us, ladies and gentlemen. A lot to be excited about. 2K's announced their level 40 reward. Different park events we're being hit with in Season 2. It doesn't come without any drama, ladies and gentlemen. You know anything about 2K, it always comes with some drama because 2K has been taking away badges from players' builds. Explicitly. Builds that were already made and maxed out are losing and or gaining badges depending on a suite of new factors that 2K has randomly added. 2K also brought back the Rebirth feature that allows you to upgrade your player to a 90 overall without having to put in any work or money. Let's talk about all of that, huh? How about that? Subscribe to the channel and let's get straight into it. Hey, excuse my voice, by the way. I was at a Lakers home opener and I lost it screaming. Things started off, NBA 2K's Twitter account, they said, Season 2, Build Your Empire is almost here. Anyone can be the next MJ, whether you're climbing the ladder to NBA stardom or running the streets or building your dream team. Full details here, linking to their courtside report, where they did proceed to give us more details. We'll start things off with their level 40 reward here, which is a skeleton mascot. That's pretty unique. Can't say I've seen that before in previous video games. So if you want to grind to level 40, you did it in season 1, you got the go-kart, you do it in season 2, this is your reward right here. 2K also says you can redeem a breast cancer awareness shirt at level 1 to support Breast Cancer Awareness Month. That's fantastic, all for a good cause. They also commit to adding new quests to, I guess, re-immerse people in the RPG experience if you've played through it all. Obviously, the quests give you additional XP. Use that XP to level up your player and get to level 40. Here they show images of some of the rewards you can get. Look at this little gold medallion here, the skull ring over here. So some of y'all are heavily into accessories and clothing, so this is the type of stuff that might excite y'all. Personally, I don't care. Look at me, man. Look how happy I look. I'm watching Bill Burr perform live with my buddy Chris. Those are memories, man. Incredible jokes. 1.5 hours of just banger joke after banger joke. And I use today's sponsor, SeatGeek, to purchase my tickets. The great thing about SeatGeek is it takes tickets from all over the web and it puts it in one place so you don't have to do the dance trying to figure out if you can find cheaper tickets elsewhere. Not only that, but it rates every ticket from 0 to 10. I think mine was rated 5.9, but I really wanted to go, so I copped them anyway. SeatGeek gives you that analysis and lets you know if the ticket you're about to purchase is even a good deal. I know Toronto Raptors is coming on February 1st to Atlanta. I have to take any opportunity to see the Toronto Raptors play, period. And it had a rating of 7, so I purchased the tickets. It was a decent deal. So next event you want to go to, whether it's a comedy event, you want to go to a concert, you want to go to a sports game, use my top link at the description. It's code AGENT at checkout. That is code AGENT at checkout, man, and you'll get $20 off your first order. So a huge thank you to SeatGeek for sponsoring this video. Then 2K begins talking about Rebirth. So if you've been playing NBA 2K for a while, you're probably pretty familiar with this feature. Rebirth, making its debut in NBA 2K22 My Career, gives players the opportunity to jump to a 90 overall or new gen or skip 10 pre-completed My Points levels on the current gen, but only after earning the Rebirth reward. So on the next gen version of the game, that comes in the form of a quest from ATM. It is a very easily completable quest, and once you complete it, you get a new build that you don't have to pay for and you don't even have to grind. You can get a straight to a 90 overall off the rip. You might be wondering why 2K is doing that, and we'll get into that in a moment because they're compensating for a pretty drastic change they've made to all your build. The theme of Season 2 is Build Your Empire. They liken it to MJ building his empire in Chicago, and so you might see some of these billboards in and around the city if you're playing on the next gen version of the game. 2K says the fun kicks off Friday, October 22nd at 9 p.m. Pacific time with a party at Club 2K, where you can celebrate the start of Season 2 by listening to all the newest music. 2K in collaboration with Columbia Records. The method in the past of having like 20 songs in an NBA 2K soundtrack, and that's the 20 songs that'll be in there all year, is dated. The new method that 2K is going with is just partnering with different record labels in the music industry to add new music every single season. I think that's a lot more fresh. So amongst the new music, songs by 24K Golden, Favi, Lil Nas X, Polo G, Aries, and Tyler the Creator, amongst others. I think having new music filtering in and out of the game is cool, especially since that's your background music. You know, that's the music you vibe out to when you're dropping people off in the city or being dropped off in the city. I personally have to mute all this music, so it won't make a difference to me because of copyright reasons, unfortunately. So Ruffles is a very popular mode in 2K history with the 4-point line and all that, we know. Ruffles is offering a trip to Cleveland for the 2022 All-Star Game, an NBA store gift card, an in-game go-kart, and much more. So 2K is finding a way to incentivize people to play the new events in Season 2 in the game, but also outside of the game too. This is something we're familiar with. If you've paid attention to Road to the Finals or Road to the All-Star game in the future, 2K always has modes with rewards outside of the game itself, which honestly is pretty dope, I'm not gonna lie. Amongst other park events coming back, they said Mobile One Grand Prix, the Ruffles 4-Point Ridge Tournament, and the Kia Challenge. The Kia Challenge will pit players against NBA players, other players, and even mascots in a cage match duel. Look out for Benny the Bull. All Kia games earn you double XP, and completing challenges will earn you rewards. They give us visuals of what the yacht, the cruise ship on the current gen is gonna look like, so if you guys are current gen players, you could expect to see this aesthetic going into Halloween. But 2K also says here that you can trick or treat in NBA 2K this year. Yes, you heard me correctly. All day long, players can trick or treat in the dark and receive banners, consumables, VC, and more. They said on the new gen, there's gonna be over 30 different stores that you can walk into and they'll give you a gift, which honestly is the most creative integration of Halloween I've ever seen in a fucking video game. Hopefully the rewards are like worth it. Like if you get 1,000 VC from this place, you go to the next spot, you get 5 boosts, you go to the next spot. Can you imagine how much stuff you can rack up if you just walk around the city? They say for current gen fans, players must search decks 4, 15, and 16 to claim their treats. And throughout that entire day, whether you're picking up rewards or playing games, you'll be getting double XP, ladies and gentlemen. 2K's been trying to entrench themselves in American culture. Like if there's a Thanksgiving, 2K will find a way to incentivize people to play 2K instead of be with family. I always wondered why 2K was so like dedicated to being a part of people's like holiday schedules. But I guess it's because once you make something routine or tradition, you never let go of it. And 2K wants to be that thing that people never let go of. So this is 2K's attempt to make Halloween part of y'all's yearly ritual. 2K also announces the park event that people have hated in the past, but you know, it's making its triumphant return, is Park After Dark. They gave us some visuals of what it's gonna look like, almost like a Vegas-like or Egypt-really-like pyramid here with a whole lot of lights and things of that nature. Aesthetically looks stunning. You can't lie about that right there. 2K says it's gonna be dunk contests, 3-point shootouts, 2v2, and 3v3 courts in Park After Dark. Also, some new additions to the W. Have y'all been playing that game mode? It seems like a whole bunch of jargon, but maybe someone that's played the game mode can sift through this here and tell me what's changed. Only to close out reminding you to build your empire. So when that gets announced, everybody's excited because there's so much new things in NBA 2K. Can't wait to hop back on and play the game. But things take a drastic shift in the very, very opposite direction very quickly. Power puts out a tweet saying, "Your height, weight, wingspan now affects your badge count. This applies to all rebirth builds and old builds. You may lose or gain badges on builds you have already maxed as well. Example, shorter wingspans on guards will give more shooting playmaking badges, but lose defense playmaking." Which is tragic, because I have a two-way player. If I lose some of my defensive badges, because I shorten my wingspan a little bit, then that's tough for my build. That's really tough for my build. The build that I spent like 30 plus hours grinding in my career, bro. Oh my god, I can't do that again. So that's the theory, is that the reason 2K reintroduced Rebirth is because they knew they were gonna make this change and it was gonna upset people. So here, why don't you use this brand new Rebirth build to correct those changes, knowing what's gonna be different in the game. But Power followed up saying, "This guy lost 8 playmaking badges and 6 defensive badges for his build." And you can see, this guy has more earned badges than potential upgrade. How can you make a build, spend VC on it, and then have a different badge count? That's scamming. Okay, so 2K has actually just given us a very, very important update about what's going on with the badge situation. They put out a tweet on Twitter. They said this: 2K22 current badge update. For users with existing saves, the badge issue is a cosmetic display issue impacting current gen players. The server knows the proper values and the players can act on those values despite the displayed potential. They followed up saying, for players creating new saves, they'll be limited by the displayed value. That part is unintentional and we are working on resolving it at the moment. Thank you for your patience. So if you have an existing build, that's not gonna create any problems for you. If you're creating a new build though, it might actually create problems for you until this issue is solved. 2K, this is what I'm talking about when I say communication. It's nice they finally let us know. People have been frantically talking about this for over 8 hours before 2K decided to jump in and just ease the tension. Cause 2K acting intentionally to do this would be like, wow. Because if this was done intentionally, that would speak a lot. Because never in 2K's history of trying to achieve balance have they went this far, so this would be setting a new precedent. So I guess this only really affects new saves, which potentially means that if you are creating your new rebirth build, that this might impact you until the problem is solved. So this was really the update I was looking for, because in every NBA 2K update that drops, man, you rest assured that there's something that changed in the game that they have not clarified in the patch notes. Power over here is saying in the new update on 2K22, so far we know, meaning there's probably some other things. Walkbacks are now patched. There are now 3 elite spin wheels on the current gen. The rebirth build feature returns from 2K19 in a quest. Certain dribble animations have changed. Example, Damian Lillard behind the back is different. So I guess they're nerfing the ways that people have been dribbling in multiple different ways. The Damian Lillard one he mentions here, but also the walkbacks. Which is like, why not just tell us those things? It's like, now that you haven't told us those things and people just have to discover those things, I don't trust that the things that's going to be in the next patch notes is going to be everything that's changed. You're giving us reasons to doubt the changes that's being made. Why is 2K altering dribble animations? What's the point? Just clarify on those things so we know what's going on. It's called communication. And to distract everyone from all the drama, NBA 2K put out a tweet saying, "My Player Nation is back. Play out the NBA season alongside the NBA 2K community. When your My Career team has an IRL game, play it in NBA 2K." Which, by the way, is like, damn, you are committed to My Career if you're like, 8 p.m.? The Raptors play the Grizzlies on 8 p.m.? All right, I'm going to hop on 2K to have... Yeah, but that's dedication, man. Some of y'all is dedicated. You can earn 2x VC and my points, so that's 2K's incentive to get you to actually participate. And you can lead your team to an NBA championship, current gen only. So whoever enjoyed that feature in the past, it is back and better than ever, man. Enjoy yourself. The problem with NBA 2K is that it's actually challenging to make changes to the game. Because most changes that 2K would need to make to the game to enact balance, one is gonna upset the people that it's working against. Like, you nerf a specific person. Like, if you nerf my two-way, I'm gonna be upset. If you nerf big man, I don't have one yet, so I have no affiliation there. I'm not gonna be as upset. So one, people's gonna be furious either way, no matter which adjustment is made. But then two, 2K is designed in a way where you have no choice really but to either spend months of your life grinding or just pay $50, right? So you put $50 into a build and now 2K messes it up. It's a huge cost to them, like in terms of the hit their brand takes. It's like nobody's really happy when 2K is in the pursuit of balance, which is part of the reason why the devs have said ever since the launch of NBA 2K22, they don't want to make too many changes to the game, that for the most part, people is happy with where the game is at. And aside from a few different problem areas, 2K is almost in the mode of like, let's not touch anything because it might break more, and right now it's pretty good. So to move on to a little funnier story here, here's a tweet from Bleacher Report that says, "E. Cambage is 6'8", but she wants that 2K ball handling rating up, so Ronnie showed up to help her out." We've seen Ronnie in the All-Star game, okay? I don't know if he can help anybody out in that department. But as you look closely here, Ronnie has a bedazzled Ronnie on his... Oh my God. Who does that? Bedazzling yourself on your shirt is crazy. So the news is plenty. NBA 2K22 Season 2 is only a couple days away. If y'all want to see gameplay, man, tune in. Subscribe to the channel. All right, if y'all missed the last bit of news, click on this video right here. I'll make sure to catch y'all on the next one. I'm out. Peace.